coverage to Lisa Teachman, meteorologist out there who's been tracking this. She now reports to us live from Kirksville. Lisa.
Brian, we've been tracking this all evening long. John Woods, the photographer, and I took out early this afternoon to start tracking some of these strong thunderstorms. And we traveled up I-35 heading up toward Cameron, where we tracked one thunderstorm that later produced a wall cloud. However, it was the stronger thunderstorm that was just to the north and east that hit Milan as well as here in Kirksville. And we did have a chance to travel around northern Kirksville that was damaged just onto the north and western side of where the water tower is. We saw numerous barns that were completely demolished, some garage doors that were blown in, and also the rooftops of metal buildings that were split back. While we got into Kirksville, we ran into this one lady, and you have to hear her amazing story from Novinger.
It's just a horrible noise. I don't know, it wasn't a train. You know, they always say a train, but maybe I was just screaming too loud myself, but and you couldn't see hardly anything. I mean, there was wind and rain and grass and limbs and everything flying.
And it is amazing that she was in her car with her little boy. He was in the back seat in his car seat, and when all the glass started flying in as the tornado was crossing their path, they didn't get a single scratch on them, so they are very thankful tonight. And Brian, when we were traveling through here in Kirksville, I definitely saw signs of damage that could be ranked on the EF1 scale, EF2, possibly even EF3, but I'm certainly not an expert in that department, so the National Weather Service is going to have to come out here tomorrow to investigate that and look at all the damage. But we've definitely seen homes that have been completely demolished and other types of debris wrapped around trees, wrapped around power lines, Brian.